Mr. Deputy Speaker, thank you. I had not intended to speak, but as I listen to the Workers' Party speeches, I get increasingly baffled. I hear across the different speeches that they essentially agree with the many programs proposed in the budget. In fact, they want the government to do more in education, to take care of the elderly, doing more for the women, more for the disadvantaged. And in one member's speech, she focused her speech on inequalities and emphasized that inequality is a threat to our nation, that we have to, I quote, take concrete steps to remedy it. The Worker Party agrees with many of the budget proposals. Mr. Lo Thak Kiang agrees that this is a forward-looking budget to anchor Singapore firmly in the future. But yet, the Worker Party says that the GST is a distraction. Mr. Deputy Speaker, our government has put together a concrete, forward-looking budget so that we can resource all these programs for Singaporeans. In this budget, we have outlined to Singaporeans how we can take care of our seniors, to better prepare our children for the future, to prime our businesses, to help our workers in the dramatic economic changes taking place and the technological disruptions. We want to help the disadvantaged in society more. And yet, after all the speeches that I've listened carefully in this chamber, the Worker Party thinks that finding the ways to fund all these programs is a distraction. They agree with the programs, but talking about how to fund these programs is a distraction. I find it baffling. I think it is critical, I think it is honest, I think it is right that we outline to Singaporeans how we intend to chart Singapore's future forward in a sustainable manner. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Leader of the House.
What the minister say?
Mr. Long? You want a clarification?
Yes, yes. Because he's referring to my speech, I say it's the distraction. I thought the budget, the most important part of this budget, is anchoring Singapore. I'm not saying that revenue is not important, but GST is not part of the budget measure at this budget, right? So I thought it would be better. You can announce the GST of 2% intended to increase 2021 anytime. We can have a full debate here. But I wonder whether is it better to announce separately, have a debate here or debate at the budget. We have never said that the government will have to fund everything and without any funding. But we're saying and we're questioning whether or not is there any other avenue to look at instead of raising GST, because it affects a lot of people. And we are looking at whether there are possibility of other revenue. I think some MPs have spoken about it. And I think I can explore it. And we can have a full debate on this. But my point was that this is basically an important budget. And a budget which is more looking forward to the future, but GST increase can be a distraction, because then we ended up debating, is there a need to increase GST?
Minister.
Mr. Deputy Speaker, I have in hand what Mr. Lo Thak Kiang said in COS 2017 in the card to MOF. I quote, I hope he, meaning the Minister for Finance, can be upfront with Singaporeans now so that they are not blindsided by the government as they were with the sudden 30% increase in water prices. You can't have the cake and eat it.
No, Speaker, I stand what I say. I'm not asking you to hide the increase or intended increase in GST. I'm not asking the government do that. What I'm all saying is that you can, by all means, announce it well before you want to increase. It's good to increase before, to announce it beforehand. But the question is whether or not you need to announce it together with this budget. That's another issue. Speaker, anyway, I've asked at the last election, and I think the DPM, Taman promised there would be, we have enough money to spend, will not increase. That's true. So next election is 2020 or 2021, so you're going to increase after the next election. Good to announce it now, then we can debate at the rally, public rally.